Everybody Foobar Protocol. Today's video is going to be about something I've been wanting to do for a while, is installing a hand pump on my shallow well. I want to install the hand pump and still use the electric pump, so we're gonna give that a shot. This well was put in, I don't know exactly when it was put in, but it was here about 12 years ago when I bought the house, and it was just the casing, and I went ahead and put the stem pipe in and put this little pump in. So we're going to tear this all apart and see if we can get a hand pump put on it so we can use, like I said, both of them. Okay, I've removed all the piping and my down pipe in the well, and what we're going to do is we're going to have to replumb everything back up to install the well, the hand pump well head. And this is the black PVC pipe. It's a like a hose type pipe, hard hose type pipe, and this is a foot valve that goes on the end of it. And this foot valve keeps the pipe primed, and it's a must to put on your wells, on your shallow wells especially. But let me get to working here. What I'm planning on doing is this coupling is going to come off. It's a schedule 20 or 10, and we're going to go with a schedule 40 to make it more rigid. But we're going to take a piece of 4-inch PVC pipe and come up out of that, and take a toilet bowl flange and mount the hand pump on it. Kind of got it in my head how I want to do it, and we'll see how it works out. Okay, I've got my new coupling installed, and I dropped my pipe back down into the well with the foot valve on it. Now, if my well ever went bad and I still had this foot valve on it, some people who don't realize this, you can take this and just push it up and down and get the water. So, if you guys that don't know anything about that little tip. So, what I'm trying to do is I've cut my pipe out on the bottom. This is going to be my stand pipe for the hand pump. This is the top of it, and they're on different that's on this end, and that's on that end. And what my theory is I can still work on this thing. Need to be careful not to drop that down into the well. But this is gonna go down on top of that where I can fasten it, but I can still work on it. But let me get this piped up and let you guys look at it when I get done. Okay, I ran into a little problem mounting this pump to the toilet bowl flange. It's not going to be big enough, and none of the holes will line up properly. And so, what I'm going to do is I've got a piece of it's a PVC type material in a sheet I used on another project, and I'm going to make another flange for it to where both of these will fit up onto it. So I'll cut that out and drill the holes and get it mounted, and that should fix that. Alright, I've got my flange adapter made up and bolted up, and it's going to work pretty good for what I'm going to be using it for. Like I said, to cut it out of this, I forget what this material is. It's a plastic, a soft plastic of some sort. But it worked out real well. And got a hole punched in the bottom of it. And we'll put it on and see how it works. Okay, I've got it all plumbed up. And it's just a dry fit on the plumbing. So I'm going to have to actually tear it all back down again, since I know it's what I want. And really it wasn't that hard. I've been working on it about, I don't know, 2-3 hours. And I had to do a trip to the hardware store. And I put unions in it to where I can break this thing back apart. And what I'm going to do with the sleeve right here is I'm gonna put some drill screws in it. I'm not going to glue it. That way if I ever have to get back into the well again, I'll be able to do that. So I'll get this thing glued up and get it primed and see if it'll work. Since I've dry fitted this also, one thing I do before I tear it all apart is I mark the orientation, especially on the elbows. This way when you put it back together, you have something to line it up with. Or you could pull one piece apart at a time and glue it together as you see fit, but it always works out better for me to do it this way. Okay, we got everything hooked up and already gave it a run. And you'll see right now that this valve's open to the pump, electric pump, and I'll show you that it works. Also that this valve is closed. What we'll do is we'll close this valve, open this one, alright, so it was well worth the effort to do this, but it came out looking pretty good. You'll see that I've got screws in the top and the bottom of this flange because I didn't want to glue it, and that way I can take it apart if I ever have a problem with my foot valve or any other problems. And also got unions in it where that piping can be taken apart. But yeah, all in all, it worked out great. It's one more thing off my list. So anyhow, thanks for watching. Hope is dead.